Hello and welcome to my feature highlights in February 2025 with SAP Datasphere. Another month with great new features. But before we check them out, let's take a moment to look at the amazing announcement we have made this month. The announcement of SAP Business Data Cloud made quite some noise in the market, and it puts data, analytics, and AI at the center of our portfolio. SAP Business Data Cloud is a fully managed software as a service solution that unifies and governs all SAP data and seamlessly connects with third-party data. It is an evolution of the business data fabric journey we started with SAP Datasphere and SAP Analytics Cloud some years ago, and really the next pivotal step in our data strategy. SAP Datasphere and SAC are core parts of BDC. Enhanced with SAP BW 7.5 or BW 400 systems on the private cloud environment and SAP Databricks. In addition, we are delivering SAP managed data products and inside apps. These data products follow a harmonized data model and share access via a zero-copy Delta Share API. Data products are really the central element here. Next to the curated SAP managed data products, customers can build their own data products. These custom data products can be built from Datasphere, BW, or Databricks and leverage the business semantics and datasets in a similar fashion using zero-copy Delta Share mechanisms. Very exciting. Enough about Business Data Cloud. Let's check out some new features of Datasphere. The first one, Cloud ALM. So SAP Datasphere is now integrated into the SAP Cloud Application Lifecycle Management solution for health monitoring. This enables you to check the health of one or more SAP Datasphere tenants from the health monitoring app within SAP Cloud ALM. The health monitoring capability allows you to monitor your SAP Datasphere instance through the following widgets: memory and disk usage, out-of-memory events, task failures, and admission control events. This integration eases the monitoring of an SAP Datasphere tenant in a complex customer landscape with a centralized and consistent way of tracking health of the tenants. The next one, import and export of the IP allowlist. We extended the IP allowlist user interface with import and export buttons, allowing you to export a file that lists all allowlisted IPs and their descriptions. You can also import an externally produced file and update the allowlist with an append or an override option. This feature really allows you to manage your IP allowlist by importing or exporting it to the same or a different SAP Datasphere tenant. And it avoids really the handling of hundreds of IP addresses manually, which could make the process much less prone to errors. So, all in all, very cool features helping you to use SAP Datasphere way more efficiently. The release of SAP Business Data Cloud makes the future of SAP Datasphere even more exciting. So stay tuned for more news on this over the next months. Thanks for joining me this month for the SAP Datasphere highlight overview. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest updates. Take care and see you soon.